Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is Cole, and in today's video, we are looking at my LEGO Koenigsegg Jesko Hydra mock. So before we get started, the instructions are available at rebrickable.com for free, so if you want to just go download them, you can go ahead and build this. And we're also going to have a tutorial video, which will be at the end of me talking here, so if you just want to skip ahead and watch the tutorial, it's right down in the video. So first let me explain what Koenigsegg is. Koenigsegg is a Swedish company that builds very crazy hypercars, and they build some very fast cars. They build a lot of very cool cars, and their current supercar is the Jesko, which is a 1400 horsepower track focused, you know, all that kind of crazy supercar numbers, that kind of thing. Now, if you know Koenigsegg, you might know that with the Agera previously, the predecessor to the Jesko, they had various special versions like the Draken, the Thor, the Vader, the Phoenix, and stuff like that. Basically, you pay more money, you get a special car. And so for the Jesko, there's already one special edition that hasn't been produced yet. There are some renders of it by a company known as LMM Design, which does fancy specifications of fancy cars. And basically, they have rendered this version here called the Hydra. The Hydra is some kind of monster out of Norse mythology, which has 9 heads or something like that. So basically, Jesko has 9 gears, the Hydra has 9 heads, and somehow that relates, I guess. But the Hydra specification is basically bare carbon with purple flake and purple accents all over it, and that is what I have built here in LEGO. Obviously, we can't do purple carbon or carbon with fiber with purple flake in it, but we can do black, and that's the closest thing we can get to it. One more thing before we start looking at the details, I must give massive thanks to David from Bricks Blocks and Locks, Nart from Nardvervong Carmox on Instagram, and Speedchamp Bricks on Instagram, because they gave me permission to use part of their designs in this model, because each of them has already made quite a nice looking Jesko model. So I figured, why don't I take the best parts from each one, at least what I think is the best part from each one, and put them together to make my own one. And so this is not 100% my model. The majority of it is my model. The front end is entirely from Nardvervong Carmox. The rear is entirely from Speedchamp Bricks. And the wing mount assembly is from Bricks Blocks and Locks. Now I know the wing mount assembly doesn't sound like a huge thing to credit somebody for, but it's hard to come up with a good wing mount design for this car. So starting at the front, which I said is not my design, but it is a very, very nice design. There isn't really a lot to say about it, except that it looks really good. It's really sleek. It's a really clean design. There's hardly any gaps or anything in it. So I'm very happy with how that looks. The sides are entirely my own design, and they're using this new technique, which I think will be revolutionary. This design will work very good for future models, like the Aventador, which I have in the works, and I think the Corvette also, which I have in the works, which I think this design will work very nicely. Basically, the doors are attached with ball joints, and that allows you to angle them sideways and up and down, which allows for some really advanced angles and stuff in there, so I think that's going to work nicely into future models. Now, the rear design, like I said, is entirely from Speedchamp Bricks. Basically, the exhaust system, the taillights, the diffuser, it's all a very nice design. A lot of layers going on here, and we even use the little 1x1 printed plate from the Jesko set with the Jesko logo on it, which I think looks really nice. Then we move on to the interior, and this model is not fit minifigures because it's so cramped in there, but it does have a nice interior. It has a center console, it has the sequential shift lever with that crazy feature that when you floor it and then you shove it to downshift, and then the pops into the lowest gear possible, and then it just kind of pulls, and yeah, if you haven't seen the video, the test drive one from Koenigsegg, I'll link to that down below. You have to go check that out. We also have a rather nice windshield design with levers to form the kind of just the general shape of it, because there's no LEGO windshield that really represents the Koenigsegg windshield that well. And then we have the center pillar, which technically isn't like a windshield pillar, it's actually the windshield wiper. On all Koenigseggs, the windshield wiper sits in the center of the windshield because of the weird shaped windshield, and so that's what this thing in the center is. Then we move on to the roof, and the reason I'm talking about the roof is because it is a 5-stud wide roof rather than the 4-stud wide roof like a lot of LEGO Koenigsegg mocks have. And the 5-stud wide roof, I think, looks better. It's a bit wider, it just kind of fits the proportions of the car better, so I think that works quite nicely. I'm also using a hinge brick to hinge it backwards, so basically we can get that kind of curved slope to line up with the proper windshield angle thing. Yeah, I think it matches up quite nicely, which I am very happy with. We also have the Hydra specific roof intake and center fin, which is a pretty simple design, but I just thought I'd point it out because they are specific to the Hydra. And then we have the big wing, the massive boomerang wing from the Jesko, and this isn't like a great representation of it, but I think it's pretty good. I'm not really sure how I could have done better, so I guess that's kind of like bragging in a way, I don't know. Yeah, I think I'm pretty happy with the design though. And now on to the tutorial. But before we do that, I kind of want to point out that we posted the picture of this on Instagram a little while back, and we actually got a comment from the owner himself. It's cool, I guess, anyway, so let's get on with the tutorial.
Thank you. Thank you.
guys, that is it for the video. I guess it was kind of a long video with the montage and me talking and then the tutorial, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, be sure to give it a like. Like I said, the PDF instructions are available for free at rebrickle.com. Link is in the description below. And I guess that's it for today's video. So thank you guys for watching, and thank you for all the support, and I will see you guys next time.